Minister Pradhan, namaste. It is wonderful to see you. And I am really honored that Mukesh said that that you consider me a friend. Every time I meet you in India, it's the highlight of my trip. Minister Pradhan is a star, in my view, in the Modi government under Prime Minister Modi. He has done some great work for his home state of Odisha. And it is always a pleasure to meet you and to spend time with you. Today, we'll be talking about education and skill development, an area of critical importance as India becomes a $5 trillion economy. And as Mukesh said, is going to be absolutely critical in turbocharging the journey towards that $5 trillion economy, hopefully in the very near future. Minister Pradhan, welcome, Pradhanji. And let's start with the U.S.-India Education Partnership and with education cooperation in higher education. It's one of the foundational pillars of the U.S.-India Partnership. Many, many Indians like me came to the United States to study. And of course, have built a life here in the United States, though still have a very strong affinity to India. My question to you to start off is, how can we strengthen, expand, and leverage the strategic partnership between the U.S. and India through higher education, collaboration, to really harness the economic opportunities and innovation?
Thank you, Puneet ji. Thank you, Mukesh ji. Thank you, USISPA, for inviting me to the fourth annual summit. We have our old bondage with both of you, Puneet ji and Mukesh ji. Whichever role I have been assigned in India, you never forgot me. You always very warm and cooperative with me. And before I answer your question, let me give you a big thanks. The way both of you come to help us during the second wave in India's COVID-19 crisis, we cannot forget your contribution, your responsibility towards your own motherland. Being the part of US, you have taken care of India in a big way. Thank you for that. Puneet ji, rightly, you have put a question, what is the future strategic relationship between US and India when I was in charge of energy sector and now in charge of education sector? I see lot of opportunity, lot of natural bondage between both the countries. Prime Minister Modi's recent visit to United States and the way both the global leader, President Biden and Prime Minister Modi, jointly commit in front of the global community how natural ally we are, how natural friends we are, and what are our priority area. I'm happy energy is a priority area for both of our relationship to education. 200,000 Indian students are reading in America. More than 15 billion US dollar has been earned by American university from Indian students. Starting from community college level to high-end research and technology collaboration, we have our natural cooperation and collaboration. And we are supposed to have some higher education working group at both the end. And I'm confident in this area also, because America is a great believer of knowledge-based economy, and India is a natural place. And both of you are the example of Indian knowledge-based economic relationship with the globe and especially with America. You belong to India, you adopted a new country, you adopted a new ecosystem, and you are contributing not only America, not only India, to the global ecosystem. This is the relationship between two democracies. By collaboration, by strategic partnership, both of us can not only serve our own country's interests, but we can create answer for global crisis and global challenges. This should be the nature of our strategic partnership, and I see great future of this relationship.
Pradhanji, I think very interesting. I wasn't aware that $15 billion is spent by Indian students in America. That is a very large and remarkable number. And I completely agree with you that the US and India are natural allies. Building on what you just said around how education is so important, not only to India, but to the global community, the new education policy of 2020 has been warmly received by our members. In your view, what will India's workforce look like in the next 5 years? And what will the internationalization of education, specifically the collaboration with American foreign universities, what role will that play in the education of India's workforce?
Puniji, you have rightly mentioned about the NEP 2020. After 34 years, after three decades, we come out with a national education policy, which is anyway newer one, with lot of feature looking into our global requirement. If I say in this way, we want to create global citizen, we want to develop global mindset, because the problems are nowadays not only related to a limited geography or limited community. Let us take the example of sustainability, climate. The way the globe is now discussing, deliberating, and affected by the climate change concerns, entire community, entire human community has to come to at one point and agree on one point how to face that. With this background, our NEP has given an ample opportunity, an ample scope to think in this way. You are rightly mentioned, internationalization of our Indian education ecosystem, twinning of universities, online education, global standard skill impact in the Indian students, because lot of Indian students are now part of global economy, global knowledge-based economy. It is not only is going to benefit Indian community. We want to, you know, education, knowledge, these all are global issues, global commodities, global challenges. We want to create an ecosystem in our Indian education where we will have our solution at the domestic front, so at the global front. So India and America, again, I will re-emphasize, being a democratic country, believer of democratic practices, rightly Mukeshji has in his introduction speech mentioned, how do we come out of misery? How do we come out? It is only through empowerment. What kind of empowerment is knowledge-based empowerment? Education is the instrument for come out of the misery and concerns. And India strength is knowledge. India strength is its human resource. Knowledge-based human resource is not only going to solve the challenge of India, it is going to create a comprehensive model. It's a collaborative model for global community. So in NEP, we have mentioned all such things. We want to give skill or vocational training at early stage. We want to create, we prioritize our education should be inclusive, our education should be equitable, our education should be affordable, our education should be accessible. In the age group of 3, now in India we are planning to have preschool education ecosystem in our country. That means at the age of 3 to age of 23. This 20 years, these two decades in a human being's life or citizen's life is very important. In India, this number is 520 million. We have 10 million teachers. We want to create a global model. And we have our, in India, we have our responsibility towards emerging economy. Our knowledge base is not only going to answer our concern. When this is a challenge, we have a well-thought document in name of NEP, where the will, how do we, by this year 2021, India is celebrating 75th year of independence. By next 25 year, we will have the next round of education policy. By next 25 year, India will be attaining its 100th independence day, 100th independent year. This 25 year journey is very important for India. And NEP is our document. NEP has given a pathway, roadmap to fulfill that aspiration.
Minister Pradhanji, you mentioned the Mahamari, as we say in India, that we have just navigated this COVID-19 tragedy. And one thing that has come to the fore has been digital. There has been more digitization in the last 18, 19 months than there has been in the last 5 years. In our discussion this morning with a couple of other ministers, with Minister Goyal yesterday, in response to a question that I posed to him, he said digital is going to play a very important role. Minister Pradhan, from an education standpoint, what role do you envision digital playing in this new education policy, in getting Indian education to the next level, and also bridging this divide between the urban and rural communities, as you mentioned? What role do you believe digital is going to play?
Puniji, let me inform a very good news to US ISPF friends. As I said, India has a community of teachers of around 10 million. Today morning only, at the end of this month, when I took review, how many of them are vaccinated, how many of them are now protected, around 100% of this community of teachers and non-teaching staff are now 100% vaccinated. The number is near total, 98, 99, 99%, 5. This is the number of the different states. Gradually, we are going to open up our schools. Almost all states, varying few states, 2-3 states, almost all states have started opening their own school, and they are gradually coming back to the class. How do we spend last 2 years? And how do we plan to spend next few years? Here lies the answer with digitalization. When a human being put into crisis, put into challenge, he find out new pathways. So in India, digitalization is a story, is a case to be studied properly. In last 2 years, lot of innovation come out, not only for teaching learning practices, for education infrastructure, for education administration. And in our NEP, we have given ample emphasis how to digitalize our entire education ecosystem, starting from student registration, starting from school, college, university, running, administration, starting from preschool education ecosystem, learning, teaching, pedagogy ecosystem to higher education. How to give skill training, impart skill-based education. We all need digital methodology, digital way to achieve that target. In the last 2 years, using satellite, using internet, using radio frequency, we could successfully, I cannot say we have an answer of 100%. The world is facing unprecedented crisis. There is a substantial learning loss, knowledge loss of last 2 years. But now we are confident by using technology, by using digital methodology, digital network, we will come out of this crisis. We have already come out of this crisis, but how to make over the last 2 years' substantial loss and how to create the new architect for the next few decades. Digitalization is a priority area. Prime Minister Modi in last 2 years given utmost emphasis. In 2020, 15 Nagar speech from the late fourth, Prime Minister has committed to the country. By 1000 day, India is going to put internet connectivity to all its village. 0.6 million villages are in India. We have an ambitious plan to connect through internet to all the villages. That means 1.5 million schools are there. We want to create an internet network to the, all the schools. We have reformed our space policy by opting the new space technology. We have liberalized our space technology. We want to create a new education pedagogy utilizing space, utilizing satellites. We are very committed, we are very determined to convert our conventional teaching learning methodology to technology-based methodology. AI, blockchain, AR, VR, these are the new skill methodology we are imparting to the lower grade school, lower grade classrooms. And we are very much aligned. We know the global requirement, we know the global challenge. We don't want to miss the bus. We want to utilize Industrial Revolution 4.0 in our favor. And in this context, I must congratulate you, Puneetji. You personally, as an individual, you have committed in a big way how to give digital literacy to women of this country, to girl child of this country, from your corporation, pure entrepreneurial model. Now, through innovative schemes of Vidyanjali, where citizen of this country, citizen, Indian origin citizen, those who are residing in the different part of globe will contribute. Utilizing digital way, material and knowledge to their own schools, to the community schools. So I say digital methodology is not only going to help us in the only teaching learning area, it is going to create a new education architect for us.
Well, Minister Pradhanji, we're nearly at the end of our time. We are really grateful that out of your busy schedule that you made time for us. But I have one question, my last question. Deloitte just did a study, even in the midst of this pandemic, India is a very attractive destination for foreign direct investment. And one of the things that is attractive of India, of course, certainly the rule of law, the largest democracy, great market, but it is the demographic dividend. And they also talk about in that study, we found that reskilling or skilling of individuals is really important. You mentioned the world class that Deloitte is doing. What would you ask our members? We have 200 multinational corporations that are part of USISPF. What would you want us to do to help you, your ministry, India, in the reskilling of the Indian students?
Thank you, Puneetji. You come to rescue me in a big way. I will consciously use not help to collaborate. I expect collaboration from friends from USISPF, because if we'll skill, reskill, upskill the Indian workforce, the globe will get affordable commodity, affordable manufacturing products, manufactured products for the global consumption. We don't have any, as rightly you have said, production line is not important. Whose production is important? Is he committed to the global requirement? Is he coming to the rescue global need at an appropriate time? India has proven its credential, credibility last pandemic period. So we want to, from global industrial community and agency like USISPF, an organization like yours, we expect. Let us collaborate, let us reskill, upskill and orient our students, our community in India. Let us enhance our capacity for Indian manpower, workforce. In that way, globe and interworld will get affordable quality products for its requirement.
Very important point, Minister Pradhan. It is in everybody's interest. It's been wonderful to see you really honored that you made time for us. Thank you very much. Bahut bahut khushi hui aapse baat karke. Mukesh, I will turn it back to you.